Hello there, I am Bendegúz Süli and I will be showing you a couple of tips and tricks in APTAR's reinforcement add-on.
New features of Beam in Reinforcement 5.0. The Beam tool was implemented into the reinforcement add-on in version 4.0. Now, in this new version, this has been further developed. There is a simple beam element with a rectangular section profile. I select it and click on the Beam tool icon in the reinforcement palette. The settings window appears, and as earlier, we can set different views: size of the element, concrete cover, and the element ID. On the next tab, settings of stirrups come up, where it is immediately visible that we have only one group of stirrups. First new feature in this window is the strange yellow triangle, which shows us that there is a collision of IDs. That means that the same ID is set for two different groups. Below, the ID of the stirrup group is set for one. If I go to the rebar settings tab, we can see that here we have two rebar groups and the ID of one of them is already set to one. I change this ID to 3 and the yellow sign disappears. I click on OK and place the reinforcement into the beam element. It's done. Let's check it in 3D. Now, I select this complex reinforcement element and open the settings window. I go to the Rebar Geometry tab. Here I can select which group I'd like to modify. As we can see, the IDs of the groups are 2 and 3, as I set it earlier. I choose the group number 2 and change the straight end of it to the once bend. I set the length of this bend part for 100 mm. This modification is immediately visible on the preview picture, but when I click on OK, it appears in the 3D model. But the bend was not done in the right direction. Go back to the settings window and I can modify the size of the bend to be minus 100 mm. The direction is now in the right direction. Let me make an undo. Up until now, we could only control this with values and with the plus or minus prefix. The next feature is a special hotspot on the bend. Grabbing this hotspot with the cursor, I can turn the bend in any direction. But it is important to know that the other rebar in this group will be turned to the same angle symmetrically. It means that there is a new option to turn the bend not only in a vertical position, but I'm also able to turn it to, for example, 45 degrees. I want to modify the other rebar pair on the top of this beam. The element is selected, and I open the settings window again. Select group number 3 and modify the geometry of it to the bent up straight end type. I set the bending value and click on OK. In the 3D model, the bending is visible, but once again, it is in the wrong direction. Click on Undo and open the settings window again. Set the bending value for minus 100. The direction is almost good, but the bend size is too big. I set a little bit smaller value for it. Now it's better, but this was the old method to set a good direction. I click on Undo again. I set the values without a minus prefix, then click on OK. In the 3D window, I can find some purple hotspots for modification on this rebar group. With this hotspot, I can move the bend in the axis direction of the rebar. With the next hotspot, I can change the bend size in two directions. With the hotspot in the center of the rebar, I can change the length of the rebar. And finally, with the hotspot on the perimeter of the rebar section, I can turn the rebar to the right position, even in 45 degrees. This turning option was not available in the earlier versions of the program. It gives a good opportunity to define the correct rebar position for many new cases. Okay, let's see the stirrup settings. I open the settings window and go to the stirrups settings tab. Here is, as I said earlier, only one stirrup group. But I'd like to have groups with different allocations, so I define three groups. The yellow sign appears immediately, because the two newly created groups have the same ID as the first one. I set different IDs for these two groups, and the warning sign disappears. I click on OK. There are no changes in the position of stirrups, because I did not set a different distance between stirrups in different groups. I go back to the settings window. On the placement page, I can find all three groups in the drop-down list. For the first group, I set the distance at 100 mm. For the fourth, at 200 mm. And finally, for the fifth group, I set 100 mm again. There is an option to set the distance of the first stirrup from the end of the beam, which I set for 0 for now. Click on OK. The differences between the three groups are clearly visible now in 3D. 100 mm in two groups at the two sides of the beam, and in the middle, the distance is 200 mm. I open again the settings window, and on the stirrup settings tab, I change the length of all three groups. Clicking on OK, we can see how the stirrup placement was changed. I go back to the floor plan, and what we saw in 3D, we can also find in the 2D representation. In this view, it's possible to change the length of stirrup groups manually, with the purple hotspots on the end of them. When I grab this hotspot and move it, the length of the group and the quantity of stirrups will automatically be adjusted to this new size, keeping the distance between stirrups. Thank you for listening.
I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, feel free to contact us at one of the email addresses in the description. You can also visit our website and find out more about our solutions. Link also in the description. Have a good day.